Hello, I'm Todd Tolbert. I am the radio coordinator for the Michigan Department of Transportation. Today we're going to give you a little bit of background into our radio communications. We're going to learn how to use the portable radio as well as the mobile radio today. Why does MDOT still use radios? MDOT still uses radios because they are an effective, reliable, instant, and secure way to communicate. It allows communication with large groups of people with the push of a button. We use the radios for daily communication with an MDOT, but they also gives us an open line of communication with police, fire, counties, and many other entities. The state of Michigan's radio network, Michigan's Public Safety Communication System, or MPSCS, covers the entire state of Michigan and is built to public safety grade. It is a stable, hardened, secure network owned and operated by the state of Michigan. Why don't we just use cell phones? In an emergency, cell phones may not work. Commercial cell phone systems are not built to the same standards as the state of Michigan radio system. The key factors are redundancy and security built into the system. Backup generators and a team of qualified technicians are on standby in case of system failure. If a tower goes down, the system automatically reroutes traffic. The network is also monitored 24/7, 365 days a year. If there is a statewide event, this closed network will provide interoperable communications to MDOT and all first responders. What is a template, zone, and talk group? A zone is a set of channels or talk groups. Each radio is programmed with multiple zones. Each zone can hold up to 16 talk groups or channels. This collection of zones and talk groups is known as a template. To communicate with others, you will need to select the correct talk group. Please note that one talk group can be in your radio multiple times and in different zones. In the past, MDOT has used a variety of templates depending on factors like geographic location, position within MDOT, and type of radio. With advancements in technology, MDOT is moving toward a single standard template that will include every region's top talk groups, all 83 counties, as well as an E-zone for emergencies. The standard MDOT template will be programmed on all MDOT radios regardless of location or position. Depending on your role within MDOT, special zones will be added to your radio. The standard MDOT template. The first seven zones are named by region. Within each of these zones is the region's top channels or talk groups, up to 16. Your regional zone will have most of the talk groups you need for daily communication. Zone E is the emergency zone. This zone is a group of regionalized dispatch centers with 24/7 monitoring for emergency services. This zone also includes two MDOT emergency talk groups, MDOT SW1, MDOT SW2. These are the go-to talk groups MDOT will use in a statewide emergency. The F zone is a group of tactical channels used for incident communications. The zone includes direct channels that communicate radio to radio and do not transmit over the statewide trunk system. These channels operate in line of sight, and in most cases operate up to 2 miles apart depending on the topography of the land. Direct channels are denoted with a D at the end of the talk group name. If you feel you need an event talk group, please contact your regional radio coordinator. These talk groups are used for special events and must be requested to be activated. The next six zones are county comm talk groups. These zones hold all of Michigan's 83 county communication channels. They are organized by their assigned county number and arranged in groups of 16 counties per zone. Each county uses their comm channel a little different, but this is still an open line of communication with every county within the state of Michigan. Y zone is designed for special manager talk groups. Z zone is used for MDOT's first responders. Y and Z zones will not be programmed into your radio if you are not deemed a manager or first responder. Operation of the portable radio. Today, we're going to talk about the APX 1000, its operation, and how to use it for our communication purposes. To turn the unit on, we press and hold the top button for 3 seconds. You can see in this example that we're in the Superior Region template on the Superior Operations Talk Group. We're going to go through some of the buttons on this so you know what they are. Turn it to the side. This is your push to talk button. This is what you're going to use when you want to communicate. We're going to look at the button on the top with the one dot. That is a backlight button. The two dots on the bottom, it tells you what site number your radio is affiliated to. The button on the top is your power button and your volume button. It's a multi-feature button. The orange button on the top is not programmed, but it is an emergency button on some radios. MDOT does not use this feature. To change the zone for this radio, we will use the zone button in the middle ribbon with the two dots. Now you will use the up and down arrow button to select the zone that you want to go to. Each region has their own zone with their top 16 channels, starting with Superior, North, Grand, Southwest, Bay, Metro, University, and the MDOT Custom Zone. You can select your talk group by either pushing the button one time, or you can go to the talk group you want and don't touch anything. After 3 seconds, it will select the talk group you're on. Within a zone, you can be at any talk group, but if you want to get back to the very first talk group in the zone, you will press and hold the home button. It will take you back to the first talk group within that zone. It's also important to note that once you're in the talk group selection mode, the knob will keep spinning around and around, going through the 16 talk groups over and over again. It's also important to note that a single talk group could be in this zone multiple times. They do this so you can find this talk group in a hurry. Operation of the mobile radio. This is the Apex 4500 with the 050 control head. All of these radios are installed within MDOT trucks. We're going to run through a couple of operations on how to use this radio. This is your power button. It will turn on the unit. This is the University Region Zone. You can see from the ribbon here, there's a couple different options. This button changes our zone. We will use this button to go between the different zones. Here's Metro Zone, Bay, Southwest, Grand, North, Superior. Dynamic zone is blank. We have the comm channels, and they go in groups of 16. Event channels, those are in groups of 16 as well. Then we have the E zone, the statewide zone, or emergency zone as we call it. To select your zone in this, you push the home button. The home button will lock you into the zone. Now you can use that same knob to go between the talk groups within that zone. MDOT Statewide 2 is one of the channels that MDOT will use in a statewide emergency. If things go bad, we're all going to go to MDOT Statewide 1 or Statewide 2. I'm going to go to the University Operations channel. That's the main talk group for the university zone. So now we're going to flip through the different talk groups within the university region. We're going to use the knob here, and this is going to go through the top 16 channels that are in the university region zone. Let's see, this is the university zone for Mason Garage, Williamston Garage, Jackson, Grand Ledge, Charlotte, Brighton, Adrian, back to the university operations. You will be able to keep spinning this knob around and around forever. It's going to go through the same 16 channels, if 16 channels are programmed in that zone. Next, we're going to find the radio ID number for this radio. That's an important thing to know. We're going to use the arrow button to go to the last setting. We're going to go to the call. Here's the radio ID, but we're going to use the button to find my ID. This is the radio ID number for this particular radio, and it will be displayed every time you push to talk on the system. I'm going to exit out of there. Now we're going to go to the information for this radio, also another valuable thing to know. We're going to find the serial number. So we're going to radio info. We're going to select it. There's the serial number. The serial number is important for inventory purposes, as well as if you have a problem with your radio and it needs to be addressed. That concludes the basic features of the APX 4500. If you have any questions on operations or options, please get a hold of your regional radio coordinator or Todd Tolbert, the radio coordinator for the Michigan Department of Transportation.